بذكر الله ترتاح القلوب وتنزاح المتاعب والكروب.
إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستهديه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله تعالى من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، إنه من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. اللهم صل وسلم وزد وبارك على هذا النبي المبارك وعلى آله وأصحابه وأتباعه إلى يوم الدين. أما بعد، الإخوة الكرام، الأخوات الفضليات، أوصيكم ونفسي بتقوى الله جل وعلا في الأمر كله، فإن تقوى الله سبحانه وتعالى هي خير زاد في هذه الحياة ويوم يقوم الناس لرب العالمين. The believers, Allah سبحانه وتعالى described His beloved and our beloved Prophet Muhammad عليه الصلاة والسلام in the Holy Quran by specific qualities, specific attributes. And these attributes, he, alayhi salatu wasalam, singled out of them. Just only he described about these qualities away or singled out from other prophets and messengers. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned that in the Quran after a long journey in Surah At-Tawbah, speak about disbelievers, munafiqeen, speak about Jewish, Christians, other nations and other faiths, and at the end describe his Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam by these qualities. Haris, azizun alayhi ma'anittum. Azizun alayhi ma'anittum. Sorrow, sadness for him, what you are doing against faith, against light, against tawheed, against true faith. Harisun alaykum, concern over you all, believers and non-believers, to save all and bring them to the mercy of Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Bil mu'minina ra'ufur rahim, to the believers kind. To the believers, he is kind and merciful. Salawatu Rabbi wa salamu alayhi. Qala Allahu jalla wa ala, laqad ja'akum rasulun min anfusikum azizun alayhi ma'anittum, harisun alaykum bil mu'minina ra'ufur rahim, fa'in tawallaw faqul hasbi Allah, la ilaha illa hu, alayhi tawakkaltu, وَهُوَ رَبُّ الْعَرْشِ الْعَظِيمِ. There has certainly come to you a messenger from among yourselves. Grievous to him is what you suffer. He is concerned over you, and to the believers is kind and merciful. But if they turn away, O Muhammad, say, sufficient for me is Allah, there is no deity except Him. On Him I have relied, and He is the Lord of the great throne. These qualities reflect How is our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? That we should carry these qualities in our characters, manners, and carry these qualities to others. Give this good news to others, nations, other faiths about his character, his attributes, alayhi salatu wassalam. The nature of him, alayhi salatu wassalam. Look at that. Allah say, min anfusikum, among yourselves. Among yourselves. So you know him well. You know him and his characters, and they used to call him before Quran, Revelation, As-Sadiq, Al-Ameen, the honest man. The honest man. So they know him, they knew him well. That is believers. And for people of the book, Christians knew, and Jewish, they knew also him through their books, Gospel and Torah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala described him, his qualities, and a description of his name in Gospel and in Torah. Subhanallah al-Azim. So, how was he harisun alaykum? Harisun alaykum. Or before that, azizun alayhi ma'anittu. Rasul as-salam used to struggle so much to give hidayah and go here and there from Mecca to Taif to Medina to all Arabia and send messengers from him to Egypt, to Persia, to Sham, to here and there, to deliver the light and the guidance of Allah that come to him, to guide mankind. But the reaction from people, few people accept faith and accept Tawheed. So that hurt him, his heart, alayhi salatu wasalam, because he concerned about all mankind to come to faith, to true track. This is a job of all prophets, to let people come back to the right track. Because people, by the shaitan and desires, nafs, dunya, all that stuff that make people deviated away from the right way to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So prophets came to correct the track and the way of people to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Allah described that his himmah alayhi salatu wasalam and his love for bringing people to Iman and Islam peacefully, seeing one ayah from many ayat. فَلَعَلَّكَ بَاخِعُ النَّفْسَكَ عَلَىٰ آثَارِهِمْ إِلَّمْ يُؤْمِنُوا بِهَذَا الْحَدِيثِ أَسَفًا. Then, perhaps you would kill yourself through grief over them. Kill yourself, metaphor, that he struggled hard to bring people to Iman and faith. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has qadr, decree, destiny. Jannah has people, and hellfire also has people. Subhanallah. So here Al-Quran teaches him, alayhi salatu wasalam, and all the ummah. Your job not to get people to Iman, your job to guide and teach, to deliver the message. مَا عَلَى الرَّسُولِ إِلَّا الْبَلَاغِ. The job of any prophet, a messenger, only deliver the message. Teach Iman and faith and Islam. And the guidance is upon Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He looks, subhanahu wa ta'ala, to the hearts, watches all hearts. And the hearts who look for guidance, hidayah, Allah take that heart to hidayah. The heart is plugged and rejected. Hidayah, khalas, this is your choice. So here we see that فَلَعَلَّكَ بَاخِعُ نَفْسَكَ عَلَىٰ آثَارِهِمْ إن لم يؤمنوا بهذا الحديث أسفا. Then perhaps you would kill yourself through grief over them, O Muhammad, if they do not believe in this message. Out of sorrow. Out of sorrow. The Prophet ﷺ, he had a servant, Jewish servant. Youth. He didn't need servants. His life was very, very simple. But that out of supporting. Sometimes if you have business, if you have company, if you have anything, you hire somebody, you need it. You don't need it. Sometime. Why? Out of compassionate, mercy, supporting the family, supporting, and so on. Some people do that. Some companies do that. Hire some people just because they want to support them financially. So he, alayhi salam, didn't need servants. His life was very, very simple. And he has wives, companions, subhanallah. He had many servants. They came to him to take barakah, blessing of Allah, Rasulullah. Some of them, he gave them to hidayah, like this case we have now. Some of them, to support them financially, support them for, you know, their life, their families, like Abu Huraira, radiallahu anhu. In this case, a Jewish servant, she was a youth, worked as a servant to him, alayhi salam. This youth gets sick, heart sickness. So, duty, the sunnah say, to visit the sick, right? So, he did, alayhi salam, he visited the Jewish youth and found family around him, his father. So while he was beside him, he asked, he watched the case, it's a hard case, maybe die, hard case. So he asked him to come to Islam, to utter Shahada before pass away, before die. So the boy looked at his father, as if he asked permission from father, asked his father to allow him to come to Islam. So his father told him, obey Abu al-Qasim. Listen to Abu al-Qasim, Rasul Muhammad, listen to the Prophet. The father, Jewish, and still Jewish. But he said to the youth, the boy, listen to the Prophet, Abu al-Qasim. So the boy said, Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah wa annaka Rasulullah. And then passed away. Rasulullah left the house saying, Alhamdulillah, that he saved him, that youth, from the punishment of Akhirah, hellfire. Last word, and only one action, shahad. Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah wa ashhadu anna Muhammadan Rasulullah, and passed away. Only, just shahad. Rasulullah comment on that, Allah saved him from hellfire by shahad. Here we see how he concerned about this person to come to Islam to save him. Harisun alaykum, concern about non-believer and believer, to guide them, to deliver their message, to guide all mankind to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Not only that, he used to make dua to non-believer. And should learn that. We should learn that. Make in your dua, part in your dua, for your neighbors, non-believers' neighbors. Of course, we should make dua for Muslim, all ummah. But concern part of your dua for non-Muslim. For non-Muslims, non-believer. Your neighbors, your co-worker, by hidayah. Privately, between you and Allah, just on. Ask Allah, oh Allah, guide these souls, these people, to the light of Iman and Islam. Oh Allah, let them come to Islam. Oh Allah, let them understand true Islam and true faith. Keep saying that. Keep saying, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Kareem, عظيم. He wanna everybody come to the mercy of him. This dunya is test, imtihan, test, big test for all. So we support each other to pass the test. Among non-believers, non-Muslims, keep asking hidayah for them. If we have relative non-Muslim, neighbors, co-workers, everybody, friends around you, ask Allah between you, your heart, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah jalla wa ala answer and respond his beloved prophet in the non-believers. Subhanallah. He went to a Taif. You know the story of a Taif, Thaqif. And they hurted him physically. Subhanallah. And at the end of his journey, raise his hand and ask hidayah for them. In Uhud, they came from Mecca and attacked him and hurted him and his companions and killed 70 persons from companions, among them Hamza, Amm al-Nabi, his uncle. But he made dua for them, Allahumma hadi qawmi fa innahum la ya'lamun. Oh Allah, guide my people as they don't know. As what the response of Allah, Allah respond to his dua and accept them. The only prophet, only messenger left beyond him when he passed away, more than 100,000 believers. Look at Nuh alayhi salam. Ama amana ma'ahu illa qalil. Look at Jesus alayhi salam. Look at Moses, Musa. Look at all prophets, Ibrahim, all prophets. And they have long time in da'wah. Sayyidina Nuh, you know, 1,000 year, almost 1,000 year. But they left few believers. The only prophet left beyond him, over 100,000 believers, sahaba. And they spread Islam and light of Islam around the world. Why? Allah responded to his dua. Sayyidina Nuh make dua against his people. You know the story. Sayyidina Musa make dua against Fir'aun and his soldiers. Huh? Some Hud, Salih, and. Allah destroyed the nations of these prophets after them. And few just believe. But Muhammad is different. Look at that and think about that. And carry these qualities to others, to know him. Alayhi salatu salam. He's a mercy for all. He's a mercy for all. وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَاكَ إِلَّا رَحْمَةً لِلْعَالَمِينَ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ. These qualities should spread around Muslim community and act behavior, these behaviors, and spread this news around non-believers. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala al-hidayah and teaching ta'aliman lana ameen ya rabbal alameen. أَقُولُ قَوْلِ هَذَا إِنْ كَانَ مِنْ تَوْفِيقٍ فَمِنَ اللَّهِ وَحْدَهِ وَإِنْ كَانَ مِنْ خَلَلْ وَنَقْصْ فَمِنِّي وَمِنَ الشَّيْطَانِ فأستغفر الله استغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. استغفر. الحمد لله رب العالمين وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. اللهم صلي وسلم وزد وبارك على هذا النبي المبارك وعلى آله وأصحابه وأتباعه إلى يوم الدين. أما بعد, believers, still with these qualities that single out the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام from others, and Allah add these special qualities to his character to show the world this man, this Prophet, this messenger is different. Come to you, all of you, as a guidance, as a light, as a support, as forgiveness, as a pardoning from Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala before meeting Almighty in the great day, Yawm al-Qiyamah. So here we see he used to make everything easy. Make everything easy. Make the life of believers easy. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say, وَمَا جَعَلَ عَلَيْكُمْ فِي الدِّينِ مِنْ حَرَجٍ. There is no difficult in Islam, in faith, in religion. And he translated that alayhi salatu wassalam by his behaviors, by his speech, saying, إِنَّ هَذَا الدِّينَ مَتِينَ فَأَوْغِلْ فِيهِ بِرِفْقٍ. This religion is firmly, strong faith, strong deen, firmly, solid. So study and act step by step, gradually. Don't go and take the deen once. No, that collapses the faith in the heart. So to build the faith and make it strong faith, take faith and iman and Islam steps, one after one, gradually. Build, like you build your house, floors, company, whatever, build the faith the same. Build the faith. فَأَوْغِلْ فِيهِ بِرِفْقٍ. So come to study and act what you study gradually, step by step. If something hard, don't go to the hard. If something, because what Allah obligates us to do is very easy. Very easy. Very easy. However, if the person has issues to act perfectly or to act totally, Allah give rukhsa, permission, allowance to, don't do that. Like Ramadan, you fast in Ramadan, but if you travel, don't fast. Sick, don't fast. Salah, travel, combine them or shorten them. So look at that. Everything in Islam, very simple and very easy. This is reflect how this is the last message, come to mercy. Have mercy on mankind in general through that Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. Bil mu'minina ra'ufun rahim. Sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Bil mu'minina ra'ufun rahim. How he used to do that with the Prophet, with the massive, with the companions in Medina. How he used to do, act, behave with the companions. You see in the history, in his seerah, alayhi salatu wasalam. Very, very kind, very, very mercy for believers and companions. And yawm al-qiyamah, shafa'ah. He said, every prophet has a special dua to his people. Again, he said that every prophet has a special da'wah to or against his people. And every prophet did his da'wah. But I save my da'wah to my ummah yawm al-qiyamah. I saved my da'wah, my du'a, my supplication for my nation yawm al-qiyamah, to save them from the punishment of Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala yawm al-qiyamah. Also, his shafa'ah, yawm al-qiyamah, cover all, shafa'ah al-uzma, cover all mankind, all being, even the angels, subhanallah, jinn, non-believers, every being, yawm al-qiyamah, will be covered by his shafa'ah, yawm al-qiyamah. And he work hard yawm al-qiyamah is a long story. His job yawm al-qiyamah is a very, very long story. How is he work yawm al-qiyamah between al-mizan wa sirat? Al-mizan wa sirat, these two positions for hard positions for all mankind. Al-mizan, the skills, you're good and bad. So we come to make shafa'ah during this, you know, and sirat, this bridge over Jahannam. He come to support and help believers to pass. He work hard, from the first second till he get this news about whose believers, all believers or ummah or nation come to Jannah. He said, I ask my Lord Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala special mercy for my nation. So Allah give him 70,000. 70,000 believer will come to Jannah without accountability. From grave to Jannah. No mizan, no nothing. Subhanallah. So he asked Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala more. 70,000 is very few, right? Billions of Muslims. his time to the end of the life, billions of Muslims. So he asked more, Ya Allah, Ya Rabb, Ya Mawlai, Ya Rahman, Ya Rahim. So Allah gave him for with each one from these 70,000, 70,000. 70,000. Multiply, make it near calculation, you're going to find how this huge amount of believers will come from their grave to Jannah by the mercy of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and his shafa'ah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to gather all of us with him in Firdaus al-A'la, Ameen, Ya Rabbil Alameen. Allahumma aghfir lana dhunubana wa israfana fi amrina wa thabbit ala al-haqq aqdamana wa ansurna ala man adana, Ya Rabbil Alameen. اللهم اجمعنا بحبيبنا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم في الفردوس الأعلى يا رب العالمين. اللهم خذ بنواصينا إليك أخذ الكرام عليك يا رب العالمين. اللهم إنا نسألك رضاك والجنة ونعوذ بك من سخطك والنار يا عزيز يا غفار. اللهم كل المسلمين المستضعفين في كل مكان يا رب العالمين. اللهم كل المسلمين المستضعفين في فلسطين في كشمير في سوريا في اليمن في كل مكان يا رب العالمين. اللهم لا ملم شعث هذه الأمة يا رب العالمين، واحفظ الإسلام والمسلمين في كل مكان في هذه البلاد خاصة وفي كل مكان عام يا رب العالمين. اللهم تنزل بالهداية على أهل هذه البلاد يا رب العالمين. اللهم تنزل على قلوبهم بالهداية وحب الإسلام والمسلمين يا رب العالمين. اللهم اشفنا واشف مرضانا وجميع مرضى المسلمين. اللهم ارفع عنا البلاء والوباء والأمراض والأسقام برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم اشفنا واشف مرضانا وجميع مرضى المسلمين، وارحم موتانا وجميع موتى المسلمين، وارحمنا إذا ما صرنا إلى الموت يا رب العالمين. سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون وسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين. وصل اللهم وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين، والحمد لله رب العالمين. وأقم الصلاة.